Hey guys, it's Victoria and I'm so happy that you had time for a TCA Minute. Today, we're going to continue our conversation around Autopilot by discussing what Autopilot looks like from the end user's perspective. We already saw the admin console, so now it's time to discuss what your users will see if you choose to implement an Autopilot solution. I hope you enjoy what Henry and Alec have to say.
Hi Henry, how are you doing today?
I'm good, Alec. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Today, we're going to go look at the end user view of Autopilot. So the first thing we're gonna do here is we're gonna go ahead and turn on this virtual machine that we enrolled yesterday. And what's gonna happen is a user will see a lot of setup going forward, back and forth. Ultimately, they're gonna get to a branded page. So the branded page you see here is Contoso. This is the Microsoft demo that we always use all the time for all the training that we get. So customers can change that to their name. So it can be Acme, and then you can have your Acme email that you're going to need to log in. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to paste the email from what we used, and we're going to move forward and hit next. Great. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to enter the password and move forward. Let's just put that in. Great. Now, the nice thing here is end users that are gonna have this Autopilot experience, there's gonna be a lot of splash screens telling them what's gonna be happening. So they won't be in the dark. The next part, we're gonna go log in and get this machine enrolled for Windows Hello for Business. So I'm gonna go use the phone authentication going forward. I'm gonna put my phone number in, it's gonna send me a text message, and I'm going to put that text number in and get that back as my additional security verification.
So Henry, are there any other forms of authentication such as fingerprint?
Yeah. So I'm going to put my PIN here, but this is also an opportunity to put a fingerprint if the company decides to enable fingerprint that they're going to go for Windows Hello. So the next part here, as you can see, it's rather pretty quick. We didn't have a lot of policy going forward. And we're going to go ahead and check to see if all the applications are in there. And the only applications we put in were Office. So let's go check for Office. Now, what we come in through here is you can see that Office is installed and it's all ready to go.
So how does Lenovo White Glove apply here? Can it help the end user out?
White Glove can actually download the apps and policies before the end user even gets it, making it even faster for the user. And there we go. We got everything there. That was really it. Now we can go back into the console and check to see if it's there. We can see that there's a new device here being managed by Intune, and it's compliant and it's enrolled to all the corporate policies right off the bat. So there's nothing too much to do. But hopefully this helps people understand the end user process of an Autopilot experience. Victoria, back to you.
Thank you so much, Henry and Alec. Awesome information. If you guys have any extra questions, be sure to reach out to your TCA or check the links in the description for more information. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.